It's an honor to be with you this morning as we walk with Jesus, as we're here and present, holding our palm branches, as the gospel said, as they did, and laying them down as a sign of honor. But then being present as well as the crowd who says, "Crucify him." And that was the reality. The same people that welcomed him into that city also shouted, "Crucify him." It's a very strange week coming up, and it is good to walk with you as we walk with our Savior during this awesome and sad and beautiful and terrible week. This week is strange in many different ways. The other priest that lives with us, Father Josh, he's a strong guy. We were playing volleyball a couple weeks ago with the kids, the teachers versus the kids, and we were both wearing short sleeve shirts, and one of the teachers came up to me and said, "Father, you should not wear a short sleeve shirt when Father's wearing a short sleeve shirt." I said, "Why?" They said, "Well, your arms aren't as big as his." I said, "You mean it's embarrassing to be like?" She said, "Yes." I said, "That's terrible." Can you imagine she would say that? But he's strong, and he used to pitch. And when we were in the seminary, we had a baseball game, and I just took a mitt, and I said, "Hey, just throw me a pitch." And he threw it. I was like, "Is that all you have? I thought you were the strong guy. I thought you used to pitch." And then he said, "Okay." And he doesn't like to be challenged. So he wound up, and he threw a pitch, and it took my glove, and my glove, I like slammed it off, and it popped right into my glove. And it killed my palm. It smacked it, I felt it, the glove went off, and that thing stung for a week. Well, brothers and sisters, this week is like those two pitches. The first pitch might be like us for the whole year. "God, is that all you have? I don't feel your presence. I don't feel you. I don't even know that, are you even here?" But this week, we feel it. This week, perhaps, if God has not been very present to us this year, these times, this week we're going to feel his presence. We're going to feel through the liturgies that we have here. We're going to feel that he is present. We're going to feel what he felt. On Holy Thursday at 7 o'clock, the Mass of the Last Supper, it starts very triumphant, like this Mass. It starts triumphant. We sing the Gloria, we ring the bells, everything seems happy. And then Jesus washes the feet, as we will wash the feet of 12 parishioners. He says to serve one another. And then all of a sudden, after Holy Communion, the altar gets stripped, everything gets turned off, and Jesus is carried from the tabernacle to a side tabernacle over here where there's a garden set up. So it's as Jesus is going to the garden. But everything at the altar is stripped to remind us that he will go away, that he is leaving us, and we will feel it. It's a beautiful Mass. If you've never been, you need to go. And then on Good Friday, we will walk in, and the first thing I will do is I will lay down in front of the crucifix, because at 3 o'clock on Good Friday, at the Liturgy of the Lord's Passion, we will start that liturgy at the same moment that he died for you and for me. And we will fall down in honor of him who died on that cross. And we will get a chance to venerate the cross of Jesus. Not his cross, obviously, but a cross to show our love for his love for us. We will feel it. We will feel the emptiness of his death. And then on Holy Saturday night, church will be dark at 8 o'clock for the Easter Vigil. It will be dark, and we will start outside with the only light being the light of a fire, the light of the risen Christ. And then we will walk in with a new Paschal candle, and then everyone will light their lights from that light. And all of a sudden, the light of the resurrection spreads to all of us. And then the lights come on, and then we read the readings that lead us to the point where Jesus, that lead us to show us that through history, it was predicted that something like this will happen. But then we will read the gospel to tell us that it happened. And then new members of our church will be baptized to share in the light that we have received. So brothers and sisters, this week, if you have never been, it is awesome because you will feel what he felt. We will feel what those people there felt. If perhaps we have not felt the presence of God in a real way, we will feel it this week. So please join us as we walk with our Savior so that we can feel what it feels to be, as Jesus said, abandoned, but then feel what it feels like to feel the power of his resurrection on Easter, Good Friday, on Good Friday, Holy Saturday, or Sunday morning. We cannot feel the power of the resurrection until we feel what it means to be abandoned. And so, brothers and sisters, let us walk with him so that we can feel his power and his love for you and for me. Praise be Jesus Christ, King of the universe.